Welcome once again to this lecture series in Chemical Reaction Engineering 1. We will continue with the next topic from chapter number 8. So we will study now the performance characteristics, kinetic studies and design principles. So far we have seen a general time concentration behavior for plug flow and mixed flow reactors. They are an aid in visualizing the actual progress of the reaction. Qualitatively we have seen. Comparison of this figure shows that except K1 is equal to K2, the plug flow reactor always requires a smaller time than does the mixed flow reactor to achieve the maximum value of R, that is desired product, which is all most of the times is intermediate. The difference in times becoming progressively larger as K2 by K1 departs from the unity. So this requires a smaller time than does the mixed flow reactor to achieve the maximum concentration, and the difference in times becomes progressively larger as K2 by K1 departs from unity, whether it is greater than 1 or less than 1, but it is not unity. In addition, for any reaction, the maximum obtainable conversion CR, we denote it by CR max, in plug flow reactor is always higher than that obtainable in mixed flow reactor. In PFR, it is always higher than in MFR. This verifies the conclusions arrived by qualitative reasoning. So we have so far seen, we have visualized just, and by intuition we have decided what kind of distribution is there. Now we will quantitatively verify this, and for that we will see the models. So first let us discuss this figure. Now here XA, that is 1 minus CA by CA0, is on x-axis between 0 to 1, and here this yield, overall yield, whether it is R by R plus S for this reaction, A giving you R plus A giving you R, R giving you S, or it is R by A or CR divided by CA0 minus CA, all are same representations of yields. So these yields, if we compare mixed flow with plug flow, okay, so we know the definitions of instantaneous yield, we know the definition of overall yield, so these are all fractional yields. So for A gives R gives S, see for K2 by K1 is equal to 1, okay, this is plug flow and this dashed line representing mixed flow, so you can see the variation. In plug flow, you have these two values are matching, means it's just a diagonal. For mixed flow, this is higher on higher side. So yield, you can see higher in these regions, then it goes on falling as the conversion increases. K2 by K1 is equal to 0.1. So again, this is for plug flow, this is for mixed flow. K2 by K1 is equal to 10. Plug flow and dashed line for mixed flow. So these representations, K2 by K1 is equal to 1. This is departing from unity. So any value which is lower than unity or higher than unity, what kind of yield we get obtained in mixed flow and plug flow for the reactions A gives R gives S. Okay, now we'll discuss these profiles. Fractional yield curves for intermediate R R is the desired product as a function of conversion level and the rate constant ratio. These curves clearly show that the fractional yield R is always higher for plug flow than for mixed flow for any conversion level. So you can see here, for any conversion level, if you see conversion level of 0.2 for K2 by K1 is equal to 1, for K, this plug flow it is higher. Here also for plug flow it is higher. If you compare here also for plug flow it is higher. So fractional yield R is always higher for plug flow than the mixed flow for any conversion level, for A gives R gives S and when R is desired. Second important observation in this figure that concerns the extent of conversion A, what we should plan for. If for the reaction considered K2 by K1 is much smaller than unity, we should design a high conversion of A. K2 by K1 is much smaller than unity. So this is a 0.1. Okay. So you get maximum yield in this region of low conversion and then it drops. So we should design a high conversion of A and probably dispense with recycle of unused reactant. If K2 by K1 is greater than unity, now the curves are below diagonal, the fractional yield drops very sharply even at low conversions. So you can see here the fractional yield is almost dropping very less in case of plug flow in the region of lower conversion. Here in the region of lower conversion, when K2 by K1 is equal to 10, naturally it will drop very fast, but still in plug flow we have advantage. So for the reactant consider K2 by K1 is much smaller than unity, then we should design this. If K2 by K1 is greater than unity, the fractional conversion drops very sharply even at low conversion that we have seen. Hence, to avoid obtaining unwanted S instead of R, we must design A for a very small conversion of A per pass and separation of R and recycle of unused reactant. So here we will prefer this, whereas in earlier case we will not prefer the recycle of unused. In such case, large quantities of material will have to be treated in the AR separator and recycle, and it is to be recycled. Unreacted A will be recycled, and this part of the process will also have to be considered cost consideration, because when you have recycle and separator, just recycle without separator, only cost of piping is there, but separator, and you don't know what kind of product distribution you have, and separator means exactly what you may need a distillation column for separation. So it adds to the costs. Now we'll see two special category reactions and the concentration distributions there. First, A gives R gives S, first order followed by zero order. N is equal to 1, order is 1, and second reaction order is 0. So first order followed by zero order. So here first order means minus R is equal to K1 Ca. Second, rate of formation of R, K1 Ca minus K2 Cr, and order is 0. So Cr raised to 0 is 1, so simply K2. And here we define a parameter which we will come across in the derivation. K is K2 by Ca0 by K1, or it is K2 by Ca0 into K1. For a batch or plug flow reactor, we are considering our usual conditions Cr0, Ca0, is 0. No R and S is initially present. Minus Ra is equal to K1Ca. First reaction. And we know this result, we have done it many times. So I am writing directly. Ca by Ca 0 is equal to e raised to minus K1T. Integration of this. Rate of formation of R plus RR dCr by dt is K1Ca minus K2. K1Ca. Ca is replaced by Ca0 into e raised to minus K1T. This derivation we have done, but there orders were 1 and 1. Here we have first order and then it is second reaction is 0 order. So K1Ca0 into e raised to minus K1T minus K2. So this we can solve, separate the variables. So dCr is equal to K1Ca0 e raised to minus K1T dt minus K2 into dt. Dt is varying from 0 to t and Cr from Cr0 to Cr. In our case, we have Cr0 is equal to 0. So dCr is simply Cr. Here K1Ca0 is constant. Integration of this is e raised to minus K1T into 1 upon derivative of this derivative is minus K1. So minus K1 in the denominator between the limit 0 to T. Here K2 integral dt is T, K2 T. So K1 Ca0 e raised to minus K1 T by K1 first term as it is minus T is equal to 0. So this becomes 1. So minus minus this minus sign plus 1 by K1. So you get here e raised to minus K1T by minus K1 plus 1 upon K1. So you have K1 here. K1, K1 in the denominator cancels out with this common K1. We have minus sign here. This is plus. So what I am doing? You can multiply by this Cr. If you multiply, if you take out this Ca0 on this side, I am writing Cr by Ca0. So first term as it is. So this is plus term I will write first. Then this is minus e raised to minus k1t. K1 is cancelled out in both the terms. And k2 Cr by Ca0 we have written here. Okay. So this I have taken this side. So I have to divide by Ca0 here. So minus k2 by Ca0 into t. This is Cr by Ca0. So we get Cr at any point of time for this kinetics, first order followed by the zero order. Now if you want to find out Cr max, so differentiate and equate to zero. So this is the expression for Cr, differentiate with respect to t equal to and equate it to zero. So Ca0 into 1 minus this derivative is zero, first term, second term. It is minus k1 into e raised to minus k1t. So minus k1 and this becomes plus. So k1 plus k1 minus k2 by Ca0 into t. Derivative of this is k2 by Ca0. Equating this to 0. So what I can write? This is equal to this. So k1 e raised to minus k1t is equal to k2 by Ca0. So at which point this will be maximum? T. When it equated to 0. So for this condition it is actually T max. So I am writing it T max. You can write here also. Here itself T max. We have already used this equating to 0. So e raised to minus K1 T max is equal to K2 by Ca0 and this K1 is transferred in the denominator. And we have initially defined a term capital K as K2 by K1 Ca0. Okay. So this is a constant, as K2 by K1 is constant, Ca0 is constant. For a given reaction, you start with some Ca0 value and K2 and K1 is fixed at those operating conditions. So we take anti-log of this. So it is minus K1 into T max, that is equal to ln K. Minus sign if I transferred, I can write ln of 1 by K. So T max will be equal to, this K1 will go in the denominator. T max 1 by K1 into ln of 1 by K. So this is T max. Now at this T max, Cr will be Cr max. So you substitute into equation for Cr to get the expression for CR max. Same method, CR max can be obtained by substituting this. So expression, you know, minus K1T. So that value is 1 upon K1 into ln of 1 by capital K minus second term K2 by CA0 into T. So this K2 by CA0, what is T? 1 upon K1 into ln of 1 by capital K. You solve this. So here this K1 in the numerator and denominator cancels out. E raised to minus ln of 1 by K. So it is minus 1 by K only. And this minus sign and minus 1 by K, it becomes plus 1 by K. Here, this K2 by K1 CA0. Okay, K2 by K1 CA0. What is K? K2 by K1 CA0. So this I write here. K is equal to K2 by K1 CA0. This we have defined to replace this constant. So ln of 1 by capital K. So what we get? 1 minus this K. I have this K here, and here we have K in the denominator. So I want to take it common. So I will take it in the numerator here. So minus, I can write 1 minus K plus K ln of K, this 1 by K sign change again, it is ln K. So we don't have any K in the denominator, simplified form. Even if you do or don't do it, that doesn't matter, but we have to simplify as far as possible. So 1 minus K is taken constant, common. 1 minus K into ln of K, so K is taken outside. This minus sign is also out, taken outside. So we have minus ln of K. So CR max by CA0 is 1 minus capital K into 1 minus ln of this capital K. And capital K is defined as this ratio of K2 by K1 CA0. So for the reaction in series, A gives R gives S, where the first reaction A gives R is first order, and the second reaction, that is second order, and R is desired product. So you can see the distribution, you can make actual plots also. So first order, first reaction, first order exponential decay. This is maximum, and CS in this case, it is not like our first order case. So CS will vary linearly here, and then it becomes almost stagnant. So here R is completely consumed. R is not available after this point. Okay. So CA, CR, and CS. And what is plotted here? This is CA0. This is T. So CA0 to this value, exponential decay. CR, initially it is 0, then it picks up, reaches maxima, this given by equation which we have already seen. And this particular reaction, second reaction, this initial slope will be this and final will be this. So work out on these variations, visualize what is happening, and again you can make a Excel plot with these equations and play with the variables K1 and K2 and see how the profiles changes. Next, now zero order followed by the first reaction. first reaction is zero order and second reaction is first order. Now first reaction is zero order, so situation is different now, because for zero order reaction, you know, you have to carry out this reaction up to some limiting value. After that you will get conversion greater than 1 or concentration negative, that limiting value you have to calculate. So we have two different situations for second reaction. It is minus Ra is equal to K1 Ca raised to 0, that is simply K1. Rate of formation of R when A is present, because after limiting value K will not be there. So before limiting value this equation will govern, K1 minus K2 Cr, and after limiting value A will not be there, so it will be simply minus K2 Cr. Okay, so again Cr 0, Cs 0 is 0, minus Ra is equal to K1 for first reaction. So this minus dCa by dt is K1, so this is K1t and this is Ca minus Ca0, zero order, this we have done already. And what we get is Ca0 minus Ca is equal to K1t. We can write it as Ca is equal to Ca0 minus K1t. That can be written as Ca0, if you take outside the bracket, 1 minus K1t by Ca0. So Ca by Ca0 is equal to 1 minus K1t by Ca0. In this form, we have written this Ca by Ca0. Now the first part, when A is present, it is represented as K1 minus K2 Cr. So this you can write dCr by dt plus K2 Cr is equal to K1. Again this is dy by dx plus py plus q form. So you get this as a solution. You find out integrating factor, integral p dx, and then evaluate the constant, write the solution. So integrating factor, e raised to integral p dx is k2 dt. So it is simply integral is k e raised to k2 t. So integrating factor is e raised to k2 t. Solution we write, Cr into integrating factor is equal to integral of q. Now q in this case is small term, only say one term, simple k1, into integrating factor, that is e raised to k2t into dt plus some constant. Okay, so Cr e raised to k2t, this integral k1 is constant, this integral will be e raised to k2 by k2. So it is k1 by k2 into e raised to k2t plus some constant. To evaluate the constant at t is equal to 0, Cr is equal to 0. So this side becomes 0 when Cr is equal to 0. So constant can be evaluated. So constant, this is 0 means this becomes 1 and this layer left with k1 by k2 simply. So constant is minus of k1 by k2. You substitute the constant here and that is your solution, particular solution. Cr e raised to my e raised to k2t is equal to e raised to k2t into k1 by k2, this term, plus constant is minus k1 by k2. So expression for Cr you can write down, you divide by e raised to k2t throughout. So first term you are left with k1 by k2t only, minus k1 by k2t in the denominator e raised to k2t, means in the numerator I can write e raised to minus k2t. K1 by k2 is common, so we have taken outside the bracket, in bracket we are left with 1 minus e raised to minus k2t. So this expression for Cr we got when A is present. This we have defined, k2 by k1 by Ca0. So this is nothing but k2 into Ca0 by k1. Okay, this k2 by k1 by Ca0. So this I can write as k1 by k2 is equal to Ca0 by k. This we can shift in the numerator, Ca0 by k will be k1 by k2. Okay. So CR by CA0, if I want to write here, K1 by K2 is CA0 by capital K. Okay, CA0 by capital K. So if I write this CA0 by capital K and this CA0 I can take in the denominator. So I have CR by CA0 in this form, I want equation 1 upon capital K into 1 minus e raised to minus k2t. So this is valid when A is present, and A will be present up to this value, up to t is equal to CA0 by K. So it is valid for t less than CA0 by K1. How we know this? We have seen this in chapter 3. We have equation integrated form for zero order, CA is equal to CA0 minus K1t. Okay. So that means CA will be equal to 0 for t is equal to CA0 by K1. That means CA is completely consumed at this value. So for t less than this value, A is present or available. So this part is applicable, or these values will be applicable only for that. When CA is equal to 0, CR will be maximum. So T max in this case is simply CA0 by K1. So 1 by K, 1 minus E raised to this, CR by CA0 can be written as 1 by K, 1 minus E raised to minus K2T. T is equal to T max at CR is equal to CR max. So in this equation of CR, if I substitute, CR becomes CR max for T is equal to CA0 by K1. So this equation I am using, CR max for T max. And what is T max? T max is CA0 by K1. This we have seen here. Okay. So if I write this CA0 by K1 here, it becomes K2 CA0 by K1. And what is K2 CA0 by K1? That we know from this definition. K2 CA0 by K1 is nothing but capital K. So I am writing here, instead of all these terms, only capital K. So what I get, simple equation, CR max by CA0 is equal to 1 by capital K into 1 minus e raised to minus this capital K, which is defined. So this is applicable for t less than CA0 by K1. Now after this time, at t is equal to CA0 by K1, A is completely consumed. So beyond this point, A is absent, A is not there. So when A is not there, your equation for rate of disappearance is K2CR, rate of formation plus, actually it is not form, it is sign convention. I am writing it plus sign on this side, so I am writing it as minus K2CR. It is nothing but same representation, actually it is minus dCR by dt is equal to K2CR. A is absent, so first term is not there. So dCR by CR, we separate the variables. Okay, dCR by CR is equal to minus K2 dt. We are operating from this CR max to CR. What happens to this CR later on, because it is converted to S only. It is not no more formed because A is already consumed. And this is up to time t. And from where it starts? At CA0 by K1. T is equal to CA0 by K1. Here it starts. Beyond this, A is absent. So it is valid for this. So this is ln of CR, CR max to CR. So ln of CR by CR max, you can write minus K2. Dt is T. So T minus CA0 by K1. This is the solution of this integral. So this simple differential equation, ordinary, we have separated the variables and solved integrals on both the sides. So ln of CR by CR max is equal to minus K2 into T minus K2T minus minus plus K2 CR, K2 CA0, K2 CA0 by K1. Okay. Now this is plus, and K2 CA0 by K1, you know, this capital K. So I am writing positive term first. Capital K and this minus K2T. So I get ln of CR by CR max is equal to K1, capital K minus K2T. CR by CR max will be anti log of this. So on this side you have CR by CR max and it is e raised to this term, that is capital K minus K2T term. From the first part, we know this CR max by CA0 is 1 by K into e raised to minus K that we have already found out here. CR max by CA0 is 1 by capital K 1 minus e raised to minus K. First part, here it is actually form value of CR max. And the reaction is A gives R gives S. So we have to combine. So that we will substitute from this in this equation. So CR max, you have CR by CR max is equal to e raised to K2 K minus K2T. This equation. CR and this is retained, and CR max from the previous equation CA0 multiplied by 1 by K into 1 minus e raised to minus K that we have substituted. So it combines second case with the first case. So first part is for T less than CA0 by K1. So whatever R max is there, R is formed, and from that R, now no fresh R will be formed, but still same R is going to consume to get S by the second reaction. So CR by CA0, this term we transfer on the right hand side, 1 upon K 1 minus e raised to minus K into e raised to K minus K2T. So we can combine this 1 by K e raised to K minus K2T multiplied by this 1. When multiplied by second term multiplied by this as it is. So what you get, first term is retained e raised to K2 minus e raised to capital K minus K2T minus, now here minus K plus K that cancels out, and you get e raised to minus K2T only. So this is CR by CA0 for T greater than CA0 by K1. Now we will see the analysis here. First reaction is zero order. Okay, you know this. CA0 is equal to CA minus K1T. So with minus K1 slope, this line, and it is completely consumed at this point. So for time T less than CA0 by K1, it is available. Then A is not available. Here, this maximum R is formed. Okay. Some R is also converted to S. This total will be 1. Here A is over. Beyond this point, you don't have any A available. So which reaction is taking place? In this part, it is A giving, R giving S. Both the reactions are continuing. In the second part, beyond this point of time CA0 by K1, we don't have A available. So only R give S, that reaction. So this R will decrease and it is converted into S. So these two special reactions we have seen. Now, as I have shown you the plots reproduced from the book as well as the plots here. You can see so this is the plots reproduced from the book, and I have added k2 by k1 is equal to 0.5 also in that, and these are the plots which are prepared after calculations in Excel sheet for different values of k2 by k1. So similar exercise, I advise you that you do the similar exercise for this A gives R gives S, first order followed by zero order. See what kind of plot you get. You will get exactly similar plot, and then you can change with your k1, k2 values and see the variations. Nature will be roughly same. Also, you reproduce this plot for zero order followed by the first order. So these two reactions we have seen as a special category for A gives R gives S. So for A gives R gives S, we have seen three different kinetics. First we have seen first reaction, first order, second reaction is also first order. Then first order followed by zero order, then zero order followed by first order. So you can see in reaction engineering kinetics, lots of variations are possible. And still, whatever the cases we are considering, these are the simplest possible cases. Now, if you see the beginning of this chapter, we have discussed these reactions. See this. We have seen only A gives R gives S, then it can give T. One more term, one more differential equation. And there can be many such reactions. There can be 10 reactions. So we'll have 10 simultaneous differential equations. So then you cannot go by this method of analysis what we have followed so far for simple A gives R gives S. More number of reactions, 4 reactions, 5 reactions, 10 reactions. There can be more. So you have to solve all those simultaneous differential equations by using computer programs, and you don't have to do any programming now. The softwares like MATLAB, MathCAD, Mathematica, these are available, and solutions can be obtained easily for even for the complex kinetics models. This again, you can see series parallel. Again, it's difficult, it's not easy. You have to write so many differential equations defining each reaction and solve the simultaneous. Here also, so defining 1 2 3 4 reactions are there. These two are in parallel, these two are in parallel, and this A gives R, A to R to S is in series. So you will get number of, and here when reversible reaction comes in picture, problem becomes much more complex. So one reaction is irreversible and this reaction is reversible. So here in A gives R, we were having minus R is equal to K1 CA simply. And here you will have K1 CA minus K2 CR. And then this reaction. If both are reversible, still problem is more complex. And if the reaction can be A plus A gives R gives S gives T, and all are reversible, then much more complex problem. And here, more complexity, network type reaction. A giving R and S, R, A and S giving it. This is network of these reactions, and also all three combinations, and these all are competing reactions and reversible. So your problem becomes much more involved or much more complicated. So anyway, in our course prescribed for BTEC, we will be restricting ourselves to parallel reactions, which we have seen, simple parallel reactions, which we already studied. It's quantitative and qualitative analysis in batch, mixed flow and plug flow reactor, and reactions in series restricted to A gives R gives S. and we'll see one or two simple series parallel combinations like A plus B giving R and this R plus B gives S. These two only, first two reactions only. So we'll discuss this and finally we'll solve problems from the exercise based on this. We'll not get into much more complicated reactions or reversible reactions because they are not, those are not the part of our syllabus prescribed, and we are going to study the things as per our syllabus. So we stop here today, and in our next lecture we'll continue with the further topics from chapter number 8.